Two to bounce off, that's basically checking the entire thing for you.
Well, here we move into our very first game within our first set. It will indeed be Bounty slash On the Sandy has moved up aggressively, but no Sandy here for Space Station. Curious, they've got the Gene as well as the Brock there for OG.
I think it makes sense because of Bounty. I mean, I didn't know how often we would see Sandy on Bounty, not having super. He doesn't have really great range, and SSG actually starting this great. If they do get a Sandstorm, if Slash does get some confirmed damage, it could help, but I feel like they're just honestly toying with them almost on IX a little bit. Great magic hand onto Bobby. Starts them well, but Space Station, they were in a good position, but they're not the ones starting on the right foot.
Well, they were in a position that screamed to me that they were not worried about damage for IX or some reason. I understand they're not quite as strong from range as you are without, like, a very strong sharpshooter on their side, but still, this is bold positioning from Space Station. They've made it work, because that's a six shot that hits Dylan, and enough for OG to be able to clamp the kill with the super there from Brock as well. Still need a few more, though, to try and catch up, and that'll do it off a nice magic hand.
Did they think it was the wrong game mode? This is really a weird, weird composition from IX. And if they can cross the distance and really play off that Sandstorm, maybe.
Hercules.
But, I mean, Slash hasn't charged his first one.
Right, we haven't seen one from him yet at all. So we were asking how good the Sandstorm is. Well, how good is Sandy just with basics at this point? Because they have not been particularly impactful so far. 5-3 now in favor of Space Station. And they've kind of ceded some of that aggressive positioning they had earlier. Now that they have the lead here in Stars, they can play a bit slower.
Yeah, but SSG, I think the control in their composition is just so good. The balls of fire from Penny mean you can't really just sit behind cover. Now that the timer's running down, IX recognize what they have to do. They're just ignoring the Penny turret, though. So some of these choke points just getting locked out, teams getting separated, and
Slash
finally they deal with it. But
I don't understand how Slash can even make his way in. He's taking so much chip damage up to this point. Just for trying to show his face, they fully neutralized Slash here this entire match. Dylan, I'm so strong now with 3 seconds left. Get pulled back in by the magic hand. Eight, IX at the last moment, they take it. 8-7, what?
That was the BB. That was straight up just the BB. They all got stuck in the corner. They had to spread a little bit more, maybe get into a place they could focus her, but I'm so strong just walks in and cleans up two immediately. OG going down was so bad. 5 stars given up at that last second.
He was so valuable, man, and that last push was huge. And I do stand by my statement that Slash was largely irrelevant there in that game.
Agreed.
But IX able to make that huge play at the end.
Wait, did he not? He didn't get a single Sandstorm.
I don't think he did, no.
He could have actually played this entire game with just the movement. He didn't even need to touch the attack whatsoever.
I don't know how much value you're getting out of it, but here's this last play.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and the magic hand pulling in, and they thought they could turn it to equalize, but actually, honestly, that kill made things worse.
Yeah.
That last done it just a little bit slower, they wouldn't have ended up caught in that corner, but...
Or even
just
the
breaks.
Kill off the magic hand, going to a different target. It will be the Sandy yet again, the Brock and the Gene. And it looks like the same composition from Space Station again as well. It's Slash, much like in the first game, kind of getting used up.
Yeah, for sure. I do like the Brock pivot, though, being able to spam with the Incendiary onto these bushes. Really strong. That's kind of the only cover you really get if you want to be bold and aggressive. And they're in a much better position now, IXR. Chepo getting a lot of pressure here, and I think OG is not running Incendiary, actually. I think OG's running Rocket number 4. We'll see once he fires his next shot. And yeah, just to have a little bit more poke. So more burst damage potential from OG, but if Chepo can keep dodging these shots, it won't really matter too much.
What's feeling like, isn't it? Like this positioning here from Chepo on the right is basically just saying that I feel confident I'm not going to be able to hit enough shots.
Yeah, you're
got
not
that magic
me.
Hand ready to go as well, so you must be so careful about your positioning. But it's the other side, Bobby, with the magic hand that finds an I'm so strong drops here first. But this is still scary. They're being pushed into a choke point, even in the 2-on-3.
Yeah, but there's so much spread damage between Gene and Sandy that it could be it. Slash just walks in and picks up OG, and no one can really chase it down. Magic hand is up for Bobby, but not really ready to go. But Penny starts are firing away. Look how far back the Brock is being pushed on the left side.
Yeah, I'm so strong, can't get in to make these trades that are necessary for IX Gaming. Space Station's out in front 5-2 and feeling pretty good about it. Slash has made use, I think, of this HP pool on the Sandy, but virtually nothing else has been used, I don't think. That makes me think that this is worth picking here yet again.
No, man.
No, I like it.
Yeah. It's cute. Watching him walking around half asleep.
Sleepy, you know?
It's intimidation, really. I can beat you with my eyes closed, but I can't dodge those shots with my eyes closed. He goes down trying to back up from OG, but there's no cover. They're stuck in the corner, and I'm so strong, I could keep firing here. Magic Hand equalizes, and now I think Tyrant has to be really careful because this lead won't be out of their hands. Gets pulled, goes down. Now advantage towards Space Station, though. They get the trade at the last second.
They did get the trade back, so that's enough. It's 14-11. I'm so strong wants to come in and trade it back out, but not this time. Space Station, hold on to even up this set on this map, and I love when it happens like that. A lot of the times we see mirror matches and compositions, especially at a high level. Not this time.
Yeah, it looks like SSU pulling out the same thing. Yep, same both ways. The Sandy coming back in, but now Slash gets the neutral star, playing a little bit more aggressive. I'm so strong gets a little caught out, still running the incendiary, still rocket number four on the other side. So difference in opinion and just star powers too. Slash much more aggressive, and I think this is the look that you need to make the Sandy work.
That's right. Slash is going to have to be really, really strong in terms of his dodging. And again, getting in, finding some damage, getting back out, charging up that super enough to allow it to be impactful. Because if you're picking Sandy just for the primary fire, it ain't enough.
And the slower this game is, now that they have the neutral star, the better it is for IX. If they can just not die for the rest of the game, they win. Obviously, you don't want it to be a 1-0 win. That's just scary to have to maintain. But Slash walks out into some of Tyrant's spam. Magic Hand charged and ready for Chepo on the left side. And even just holding that super targeter, honestly, is going to make SSG play more defensive.
It absolutely is, as we're still not quite there for Slash here just yet, who has to start falling back. But this is what's so big. There's so much pressure on OG and Tyrant Star to hit the shots just like that. Slash falls yet again 2-1 now in favor of SSG here in your finals. And that just changes the texture of this whole map. Now Slash must be so much more aggressive.
Yeah, Balls of Fire are actually making so much room. Just one landing in that choke made it so Slash went down. There was no other way for him to get out. The salvo, rockets coming in from Brock. The barrage takes down that wall, and now have a little bit less cover, honestly. Nowhere really for Dylan to play. All those shots coming in, barely lives. And on the other side, OG goes down. I'm so strong.
That's huge. And now look at that IX turn tail immediately. A pull in from Dylan. They get one more kill. That puts IX out on top, and they drop the Sandstorm. Good luck getting in. That's 12 seconds of time.
Yeah, I was
going
to say that by so much time. So hard to walk into it. Now Slash can just end in a bush and still be invisible the whole time. He's
only worth two, remember.
Might burn down Bobby. They didn't know. Even if they get it, it's not it.
Yeah, 7 seconds left here. Remember, Slash only worth two now at this point. I'm so strong, and Dylan are really the targets that you're looking for, but Dylan finds a kill. That should all but sell. His life matters not. Bobby, I'm sorry, buddy. That kill won't get it done. IX 8-6 come out on top.
Definitely a great comp change, a great pivot from them by the end. We finally saw that Sandy value in the late game. I will say, when he charges one super, maybe on top of that for more sustain, just being able to spam across the gem cap. But with Sandy in the game, I don't know if that's where we're going to go. We will see Shelly. We'll see Pam. That's the sustain for the other side. That could be. I'm gonna drop a healing station in the sandstorm.
In the sandstorm, you're right. Yeah, I mean, making up for not having that other star power just yet, I suppose, as Bobby gets right into the thick of things early on and finds the first pick of this match, and that's gonna make things so much harder. They're gonna need Dylan to come in and try and regain some space. But look where Tyrant Star is. It's all in aggression from Space Station Bobby right there as well as Dylan drops, and why not complete it? They take down all three for a wipe.
Shelly charges her super so fast. I'm so strong using the one up to get back into the fight. Has the damage amp gonna drop it somewhere soon, but Sandstorm gonna make it so tough for IX to know where they have to be shooting.
They have to drop both these supers just to try and reclaim some neutral space, but great uses there to allow Bobby to make an up close and personal visit. I'm so strong. The 8-bit not getting enough value here this time, and gonna take down the super while he's at it. Why not?
Tyrant Star backing up, has super ready. No one's going to be playing close enough, I think, for the Shell Shock to really find the value that it needs, if that is what he's running. Bobby very aggressive on the side with a damage reduction, cleaves straight through, gets 8-bit, and almost takes the damage amp down as well.
That's so impressive. I mean, that's what they were trying to do with those two supers. The Pam super as well as 8-bit was buy some space on the right-hand side to move in, but Bobby denies it all with this Rosa performance here so far. But OG's got to be careful. His life is so much value, and that's 5 gems, but they are on Space Station's side.
Bobby's waiting for someone to try to go in, uses the Sandstorm. He gets it all 9 gems right now. Only one more to start the countdown. That one's definitely not going to him, but Plant Life's going to keep him alive. Get him back in the fight faster. If someone just gets a little bit too far forward, if the gem goes just towards their side instead, that could start this countdown right away.
Oh, and I'm so strong, feels like he has to step up for it, but catches the hands from Bobby once it gets inside those bushes. It's so funny. Ordinarily, you don't want your gems on a Rosa, but if it's the end, you kind of do, because she's so hard to kill, so it does end up working out. Another use of the Sandstorm on both sides. That makes it hard to know where the gem falls. Bobby can't make it in because of the cover fire from I'm So Strong. One gem away potentially on Space Station, but IX are climbing back in.
And they actually, he does get the last gem, but they don't know I'm so strong is right there. Might be able to get the pick, but the damage reduction, the super is up for Bobby. Has to pop it a little bit early. The damage amp almost burning him down. What a rough position to be in, but with OG coming back, that's a lot of cover from the Sandy.
And that should be enough. 10 stars down there. The only way is if they can get another gem to match, but they could not find it. Space Station, with this aggressive use of the Shelly and the Rosa, come away with the very...
Probably BB, realistically, just because of the influence she has on the game. And BB coming out, though, on the other side, too. They're dropping that and pulling out a little bit more tankiness.
Yeah, so no Shelly. It'll be a BB in that spot. But, I mean, I don't know if you can make an argument that they're losing damage. BB feels like can do so much at times. And Bobby, yet again on a Warpath Slash, has had a rough overall match here so far. Tyrant Star finds one more with I'm So Strong. It's shades of the first game here all over again as Bobby and the rest of SSG find three to get mid control.
They're just not ready for Bobby's aggression. He did the same push twice in a row, and the Sandy was left alone in middle. Not enough damage to stop Bobby from pulling that off, and they have the 8-bit bigger radius on the damage amp super, so might be able to get just a little bit more out of it. I'm So Strong being the one pivoting to the spike, but Bobby going in with his damage reduction in the backside.
Hello.
Catches I'm So Strong. Almost every pick is going the way of SSG, but the gems are still even.
Bobby has been a maniac so far here on this Rosa, and you're right, IX do not have an answer. They might need something like a Shelly in their own corner to try and slow things down. OG with 5 to his name, but look at Bobby yet again on a Warpath. Gets the kill, makes it to the bushes. Dylan finally finds a much-needed kill, but Tyrant Star is right there to clean it up. 7 gems now on the side of Space Station. Slash hungry for a few return kills, but Tyrant Star, insatiable, finds one more, but he will lose those 3 gems.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, he kind of, that was a miracle that he was able to do it. Bobby actually saved his damage reduction last time, is now using it to just rip straight through the back line. They have the countdown started, but Bobby able to hold on to it.
And remember, Tyrant Star's life is of no value now at this point. He can indeed be that frontlining force here for the squad that they need. Bobby's still doing a lot of the work, despite his 2 gems being quite valuable. Sucking the team away, gets the kill. That'll be the match. And we are done just like that. Space Station Gaming even things up. And I feel like we do see some bulls a good amount of the time here on this map.
Yeah.
I would be surprised if we don't. Already one there for Tyrant Star, plus an 8-bit. And then a BB, another Sandy for Slash, and a Rosa there for Dylan.
Yeah, I was going to say, this to me feels like Bull the map.
Yes.
Whenever this map is in rotation, this is absolutely me grinding up Bull. Slash going down early to Tyrant Star. No one protecting him. No one protecting him in the back line. Bobby actually has his supercharged already on his Sandy. Not able to kill I'm So Strong in time, though. Just OG on the defense, but
it's not enough.
Decent sieging up top, actually, and OG going down is going to make this a lot tougher.
OG now suddenly spawning in. That will cut down I'm So Strong, so they got what little damage they were going to get on the side of IX. Brought the safe down. 59%. Meanwhile, Tyrant Star has been
full
chilling.
HP.
Yeah, at the top
just
side
coming
of the map,
back.
Did 14% by himself. Is hiding now inside of his friendly Sandy Super, waiting for this dissipate so they can move forward. But there's a push from I'm So Strong. Makes the one-for-one trade. Tyrant Star wants a match on the other side.
I think he might be baiting here now. He's too low HP. I was going to say, I thought he was baiting for a bull charge straight back in, but just not enough health. Dylan Chepa trying to push in and catch Tyrant Star. Damage reduction on Bull,
wow.
Just a little bit stronger than Rose's. It runs out at the last moment. I'm So Strong, though, catches Bobby in the mid lane, but gonna die to the chip from the Root Sands.
And that means Tyrant Star can start pushing in, does have this charge available, but is being cautious with it. No backup right now, so it wouldn't do him much good to go in. Now he'll break that barrier charge in, and this forces IX to come back for defense. I'm So Strong clips him a little quicker than he might have expected, thanks to Bobby, and now Space Station can hold once again.
I don't know how I feel about the there's 3 sands. Oh, there is just a lot of sandstorming going on at the same time there, and both those Rude Sands, when they were both stacked up, will stack 400 damage per second because of that at the end. Now, thankfully, that won't be happening too often because of the duration of sandstorm, but another sandstorm here on the left for Bobby, but they didn't stop I'm So Strong for coming into the objective. Drops the damage amp, and it actually distracts I'm So Strong a little bit. Still 28% though on the objective. Slash getting even more damage onto it for SSG, and SSG need to find their way into the objective and fast.
Slash does get some damage off, but it does end up falling in the end. Remember, Bull did break down that center pass, so they have a way in. Tyrant Star biding his time before he makes a push. I'm So Strong stuck right in between and just getting poked out now by OG. Tyrant Star is keeping Dylan way back on this side. They've got a decent positioning, but Slash drops the super. That might make things a whole lot harder. Tyrant Star stops to move in. This is friendly for him. He can try and get some damage in on the safe, but not enough.
They might potentially, if they kill him so strong, they had the damage amp, they had the 8-bit, but Slash is body blocking so much of the damage.
It's low.
Might just be enough.
They got it.
Barely at the last moment, the Sandstorm pressure. They walk straight in with the damage amp and they convert it.
And I agree.
Last percent
getting those rapid taps in, man. Just trying to get every bit of damage off that he could. And he certainly did. Looks like we'll be seeing relatively similar compositions, though a spike coming in this time for IX Gaming. See if this works out for them on the hand in the hand of Dylan.
It's a little bit more control, though. They have the Spike Super to be able to slow things down. Spike also very good at poking around these corners, as we see in this battle between Tyrant and Chepo here on the side. Spike Super already charged. Spike does a lot of damage, so it does happen pretty quickly. And damage on either objective just yet, but it looks like IX are in position to get the first hit.
I'm So Strong moves in. In comes the super being dropped there by Bobby, and that should force I'm So Strong out. But they got 25% damage on the safe in that time. The Tyrant Star has stayed up very far forward. OG gets Slash. Might be a time for a space station push.
Possibly. If Tyrant Star also gets his bull rush, he might be able to clear out the tires there too and opens up for his team. Slash
poked.
Getting very aggressive. That DR won't help you at 100 HP. Makes a little bit of a difference, but actually Bobby trading on the side catches I'm So Strong. Is anybody there to defend the point? No, they're not.
He certainly is going to be able to push in and get a couple shots, but he's afraid of that BB spawn. Didn't know quite where it would be and ends up falling back out. Slash now in some trouble again as OG right there with him in point blank range. Slash will drop, but I'm So Strong sees a low health Tyrant Star, spells some blood in the water, drops the BB super for max damage. Look at all these bounces. 1400 ain't bad. Does pay for it on the way out, but he did his job.
I love the way Chepo's playing Spike here on the side too, just throwing the super in front of him so nobody can pressure him at all. There's no way that the Tyrant can get in and do anything to him. And he's been alive pressuring this whole time. Might do the same thing here, but the range from Sandy just a little bit too much. He manages to get that last pick.
I'm So Strong does win that fight up against Tyrant Star. That allows Slash and IX to stay pushing up forward. Defensive super has to come out, but Tyrant Star continues to push aggressively into it. They're not ready to push any further than this as OG gets a nice snipe, but I'm So Strong is down by the safe, and it's just Bobby. I don't think he can defend by himself without a super. And in comes the BB super itself. The bounce is favorable, but not quite enough.
Not winning really on the other side of the map either. OG maybe could take down Slash, but this rude sand chip is barely going to take him down at the last moment. Tyrant Star, though, is still in, but they're not ready for Slash. They don't know he's here. There's no way they can outpace this. Slash turns it, and we're 1-1 on Heist.
It's been so even between these teams back and forth, and yet again, if these fights aren't going your way, I don't think that you have to go back and readjust the composition.
They are going to get rid of the Sandy, though, and bring in the BB instead. They saw the impact that the BB had, and
Rico as well.
They were able to do something. Actually, they do have the Sandy, but they just swap some people around. Tyrant Star actually uncontested in the back. Might pull some people back. A lot of damage from Bobby coming in. BB Bubble doing a little bit more, and Chepo has to be the one to come back and stop Tyrant.
And he's doing good defense here so far. All that Rico damage is going to look great on the other side next time. That was mostly for defense, as only 7% comes out from Tyrant Star's push. Meanwhile, I'm So Strong and Slash have secured decent positioning up aggressive. It'll be Bobby back to play defense. They don't know the positioning. Out comes the Sandstorm, but that won't impact I'm So Strong, who's winning the trade so far. OG does come in to stop any extra damage, but the BB super continues.
And actually, everyone else in IX still alive, now able to siege up on this. Bobby going in to try to push back Chepo, but two Sandstorms on top of each other. That little bit of chip damage onto the save, those 200s, it could make a difference. SSG setting up in the middle of the map, though. They have pretty all right positioning here, though, but great play by Chepo. Gets caught out by Bobby. Bounce into the bubble. No way to get out from that, but IX still maintain objective control.
This is good work from Tyrant Star, though. Not going to let Slash move in off I'm So Strong's push. OG does have the shot. Safe comes down to 52%. Meanwhile, Dylan able to find a nice kill for himself up near the top end there as well on this Rico. So far, IX have been looking the better, but Tyrant Star might be ready to change that, dashing in, and they don't know where he is inside the Sandstorm. Dylan just has to take guesses, but Tyrant Star closes it close. Shotgun, point blank, barrel stuff for the kill, and Bobby finds one too. This is a huge push now for Space Station.
They don't have the ability to get the close ricochet, though, because of where the bull rush destroyed
exactly
the tires, so not as much damage coming in, but they do end up with a lead, and Tyrant Star is still in a position to get those last couple of shots in the last seconds.
Slash is trying to push through, but he has to come back and help a little bit because of OG's positioning as well. Very, very low is the Rico in the back. I'm So Strong commits the super. It ends up hitting twice, almost a third time there as well to take Tyrant Star out of the picture. Bobby wins the trade up against Slash. That means he can drop a super of his own, but it doesn't tick for much.
Huge thing here, though, is the rude sands from the Sandstorm is keeping Rico from healing. Rico's been 400, 1,000 this entire time.
4%.
Only 4% remaining. I'm So Strong
Tyrant
very
Star
close to the objective,
but
they don't have a way to break the cover. They have to come around out one of the choke points. They have no other options.
Bobby's going to push in as well. He knows at this point that he can just walk in and swing away. 17%. Bobby has to get there faster. 1%. It was only 3. Just barely. Was not enough for them to grab the win. That means that IX, by the thinnest of marges, come out on top. This has been an incredible final. Super available. That definitely would have been enough there from the bull. But Bobby comes in 4% on the safe, only swings for 3, and can't quite grab that win. That is so clutch.
Yeah, I think maybe a little more defensive play. Again, play. Then you're allowed to play again.
Well, we'll move in. Primo, Shelly. I was able to get a quick look at down on the bottom side, and looks like on the top side, there will indeed be another Sandy there for Slash. By the way, I don't think Slash has played anything but this entire final so far.
Yeah, I don't think you're wrong, and I think we can see why with this influence right here. OG getting pushed back a little bit by the spike. Going to put that slow in the goal, make it very hard for them to stop anything, but the damage at the last moment does manage to save it. Bobby's Primo does catch it, but he's so slow. All he can do is throw the ball away before he goes down.
That's good work there from Spike, man. That slow was brutal to make sure he can catch up and keep this ball aggressively positioned, but OG steps forward, tries to shoot forward, but OG was covering the gap. There's no way you can know. A great block from him.
Yeah, now BB Bubble going in. Doesn't find too much damage. OG has to disengage a little bit. Bobby getting a little bit aggressive here in the enemy. Sandstorm doesn't know where Slash is and goes down.
He was pushed over there, I believe, by I'm So Strong. Strong now has regained control of the ball, can push it in. Remember, BB oftentimes could just walk it in if the opposition's not careful. Is stealth, but they could tell where the ball is here at this point. He's going to go for just walking in. Slash takes it over, gets stunned, though, but it's not enough. Slash able to score yet again, and now IX grabbed the first win.
That was a great, great push by them. You can see how much value the Sandstorm is bringing them. Now Slash, I think, is finally having that performance on Sandy that we were hoping for from the start. The team's definitely adapted to how SSG decided to answer Sandy. Maybe this is why she wasn't banned. They said, walk it or we win.
Well, look at this overwhelming pressure so far from Bobby. He's done it before on the Rosa. Looks like the Primo could do it as well. Just walks up and scores it for him. Sometimes Bobby just decides Space Station is winning this one.
Wait, so they could have done that? They could have won the games like this the whole time?
Yeah, apparently. Bobby just had it in him. And here it comes yet again. Remember, this is how Gym Grab went so well for him. Bobby comes in. OG is the one who gets the kill. And I'm So Strong has Slash pushed way back into the goal for another kill. They find all 3. Just a shot on goal would be enough. No, just walk it in. OG gets the point. And suddenly Space Station have grabbed the first one here on Brawl Ball.
That was a crazy play by Bobby. He
your own a bit of a push. That could certainly work for them as we move into the next game. It looks like it will be Spike and Sandy and Shelly. That could potentially be the answer. If there's a Primo in your face, a Shelly super will probably slow that down.
Yeah, for sure. The Shell Shock able to kind of deny some pressure if that does come into afterwards. Well, Shell's on both sides too. Spike super to deny some rotation potential back there. Neither Sandy charging the Sandstorm just yet. That might be the difference maker. Bobby very aggressive. Doesn't have the health, I think, to walk it in against that comp, but gets Chepo very low in the back.
That's right. He's forced to just take the shot, get the ball as far back on the opposite side as possible, and give Tyranitar an OG a good position until he respawns. So Strong has the ball way back with him, but they're not ready to make their push just yet. They'll let Slash handle this. They lack a traditional tank, so this push won't be easy for them, but they find 2 critical kills, and now they can start pushing forward.
Yeah, ball control. The ball is on SSG's side of the map right now. 2 Sandstorms both running out now. Shelly still, she has the super up, the Shell Shock to slow people down. I'm So Strong trying to get in, but the stun from the Shelly super pushes them back. Now it's just up to OG to stop this ball from going in.
But I don't think he can do it by himself. Hands back, grabs the ball, shoots it in, and IX grab the first score. But if history tells us anything, now it's time for Bobby to turn on the Jets here, if anything was learned last time. Double Sandstorms here at the beginning of the game. That stops that aggression I was just alluding to. But look at OG. I think they have an idea because of the Spike super, though.
Yeah, for sure. And Bobby's also taking a lot of chip from that Root Sand, so even waiting that entire time, he wasn't able to heal himself back up. Shell Shock means Bobby can't make much of a move for now, but Tyranitar so aggressive the main, the Spike's not ready for it. We're going to go to 1-1.
We are going to 1-1. If IX can score here one more time, they'll go to 1-1 within the set. They're not on the chance to win here just yet, but Space Station are. If they can score again, they can close up Brawl Ball, take us down to a set 5. Bobby starting to melt, though, inside the Sandstorm. Too much damage. It's Dylan that grabs that first point. They're not done with Brawl Ball just yet, though, RIX. They want this to keep going. Sandstorm has to come out on the other side.
It's for SSG, too, here defensively, and they back up, try to keep the ball outside of it to avoid any disadvantages, but kicking it back in. Now you do not want to go in there to get that ball. Spike is just kind of checking with the attacks. Bobby has the elbow drop now, so we could see some aggressive play, but smartly, he pulls back. Got to reheal. Primo really plays off of his health pool more than anything.
Getting close to the overtime, Bobby goes in, but immediately catches the Shelly damage point blank. I think this was the answer to limiting the Primo slash starting to move in. Remember, overtime will be coming here in the next 3 seconds. They'll keep playing. I'm So Strong finds one more kill. Barriers cleared, and Bobby forced to drop the ball. Thinks I'm So Strong. They can pass it past him. The Dylan can find the shot. No, OG gets in there to defend just in time.
At the last moment, I thought the slow would be enough to stop it, but the respawns just barely saved them. Range, though, I mean, neither team really has a great comp for this, so it's just whoever can get close enough, whoever's bold enough to go in. I'm So Strong has the Shelly super, knocks back Bobby, and health pool on SSG is not looking good. OG goes down two first.
Yeah, I think IX might be doing a little bit better here with their range, with all of these barriers having been cleared out. Elbow drop comes in from Bobby, but can't quite do much. He's trying to bait I'm So Strong into the super, but he saves it. Slash gets the kill there onto Tyrant Star, but it was answered. They lost the spike. But from the Sandstorm, Slash comes out. Bobby ends up falling. OG now in trouble as well, but Tyrant Star back up.
Looks like SSG might want to take this to a draw with the ball in the corner. They don't want to risk anything here. Right. Tyrant Star getting very low, though, now stuck in the enemy's Sandstorm, but no one's close enough to touch the ball. Pretty sure this is going to end up in a draw.
I think so, too. That means that we will just end up replaying this one because, of course, the margin between these two teams are so thin.
It was literally their tournament lives on the line in that moment.
And they were able to catch that ball and stay alive. We head back into Brawl Ball one more time. BB, Sandy, and Spike for IX Gaming. Shelly, Sandy, and Spike for Space Station Gaming. And I'm So Strong is already taking aggressive position and get the ball, pass the ball to him. He can just walk it in. But they do have time to get there to position for defense in time. Push the ball so they can make a big swing to get the kill and just shoot it in. I'm So Strong scores the first point.
I was about to say, this composition by SSG, there's no traditional tanks.
Right.
They don't have anyone that can run the ball in or dive onto Slash. That was kind of what won them the previous maps here, and it's going to be tough for them. Spike Super kind of zoning out Tyrant Star. The Sandstorm allows IX to take as much time as they need. If they can find some good supers here, if I'm So Strong can just walk it in, SSG need to find an answer fast.
But the thing is, IX must have had this read, right? The Shelly was the best answer to Bobby on the Primo. They didn't even bring it here this time. So, I mean, I think this is a bold competition from IX just in general.
BB's another also great answer, though. I mean,
sure.
The home run knockback,
able
to do a lot. OG the first one to go down. The Sandstorm from SSG buys a little bit of time, does get I'm So Strong caught out. Ball in the midfield, but only Slash and Chepo alive for IX. They're not going to go anywhere, but Bobby just walks in, uses that invisibility to pick Chepo.
Even if he's not Primo, Bobby only walks forward. I rarely see the man go any other direction. Hiding inside the Sandstorm now, they'll have no idea where he is. Good attempts here from Dylan, and they should finally reveal him, but he was able to weave his way in. What a pass, what a shot. Bobby ties things up 1-1 here within this set, and Space Station, one more goal, and they move us on to set 5.
We'll have to see how they play. The Sandstorm up right now, going to be thrown in the midfield just to get a little bit more control. Tyrant Star so low on the back, getting pushed out by Chepo, and Chepo can actually get a lot of zoning here with his Spike Super. Catches out the Shelly. OG's the first one to go down. Tyrant Star follows him too. The ball's getting ever closer to the Goldfinch.
This should be enough now for IX to make the push. Slash just be able to walk it in now at this point, and he does. That's going to tie us up within the set at 1-1. No draws here. We shall have ourselves a winner. That means the set 5, and that would indeed be Siege that's waiting for us. But I must not get ahead of myself. This game of Brawl Ball still to be played. Slash has played nothing but Sandy all day long. He's back on it here yet again. And clearly IX trusting him here on this pick to have done enough.
And also Bobby switching over to the BB, so able to be a little bit more aggressive here too. Hits Chepo, but gets slowed. Maybe not able to get away, barely at the last moment. The damage reduction from batting stance keeping him alive. Sandstorm now for IX. They can just control this middle area. The ball is very firmly, I think, in their control. Slash trying to get aggressive, but now they're finally moving across the field. Slash ideally can charge up another Sandstorm and get in here.
And that's going to be Bobby down. Tyrant Star and OG couldn't do enough with all that pressure and all that space that he bought him. They find one more kill, and the Tyrant Star shot in. They cleared the obstacles, and Slash scores the point. They are one more away here now from taking it all.
It's a very aggressive Sandstorm on both sides. Nobody can really see what's going on. Slash trying to move for ball control, but you're not going to be able to burn through that batting stance, BB. Bobby controlling it specifically here.
Right.
And actually, Sandstorm does run out, but SSG gets the first pick on I'm So Strong.
Yeah, OG and Tyrant Star finally working together to give Bobby a little bit of some much-needed help in that engagement. He's got the ball here now, so they have a great idea of where he is. Tyrant Star trying to stop them from moving in aggressively, wanting to move in and clear some of the obstacles, but I think he didn't get it. But Bobby finds the shot anyway. You gotta be kidding. 1-1 now.
That adaptation from Bobby at the last second was crazy. Tyrant Star is like, oh my god, I missed the boxes. Bobby's like, don't worry. I got it.
I'll just weave the shot in here where there is not one. Big super comes through from Bobby. That chips down Dylan. And I Am So Strong ends up falling as well. They pass it up to Bobby, the BB, who could drop the ball and find the big shot, but she might not even need to. Just going to try and walk it in, but I Am So Strong spawns in time to slow down the push.
The Root Sands actually chip there from OG was enough to get some kills earlier. But now everybody can just sit there and heal up in their own sandstorm. There's no way SSG can really find the poke here. Ball is on the side of IX, but no one's really, I would say, in control of it. Maybe I'm So Strong just because he has the Shelly Super, and you're not walking into that if you want the ball. Spike Super coming in just to buy potentially a little bit of space, but both Shellys have all the utility they need.
I'm So Strong goes to grab the ball first, but that's such a good super coming out from OG. 10 seconds here left now, and Bobby has the ball. Slash ends up falling. OG gets one. Bobby scores. That's going to do it here for Brawl Ball. We're moving on to Siege. Somehow Space Station Gaming have to be the better team in to win because there are so many different sieges. It can be hard to do enough damage in just one push. It should be very even between these squads as we move in to the final set here now, Kresnik, between Space Station and IX. Who will represent North America?
Honestly, either way, I think we're going to be looking good. Both these teams are phenomenal. I don't think anyone minds who's representing NA at this point. Just who ends up walking away with the $500 extra more than anything. And as we said earlier, Sandy, BB mirrored on both sides. Bobby choosing to bring out the Jean. We saw it earlier, and looks like it was a bit of a good advantage for them. It gives them the first siege bot.
It ends up being a trade, one for one on the right-hand side, though. I'm So Strong and Slash trying to make use of this sandstorm to push back. And because of that, Bobby and OG can't afford to step forward. Their siege bot already down well below half. They might not get very much damage out of this one at all. When I say not very much, I meant exactly zero, by the way. Space Station got the first siege and got nothing.
And actually, having no environmental destruction on either team is going to make it hard to get some poke in on the safe. If you could blow that up, the siege bot will take a more direct route.
Exactly.
And it's so many tiny little chokes that he has to go through that the defending team, I think, can have a really big advantage. You can lock him up in so many ways, especially with the BB constantly knocking him back.
Tyrant finds the solo kill there on the left-hand side. I think got a little bit of help from Bobby, but wins his one. Another siege bot coming in now for Space Station. They've controlled the bolts perfectly. IX only at four. There's the magic hand for Bobby. Pulls in Dylan. He drops. Siege bot level 8 ready to start pushing. Tyrant Star gets slashed as well. I'm So Strong drops too. This could finally be the push that's needed, and the obstacles are there. Tyrant Star with the super can find big damage. Drops it in, and that starts to clear him out. They only get about 22% or so, though. Not that much, but it could potentially be enough if they control the next siege.
I was going to say, if they keep this neutral zone in their hands, then it's more than enough. All you got to do is be 1% ahead at the end of the game, and we've definitely seen 1% matter more than once already in this set. A lot of bolts about to clock in for them. Looks like it's going to be 6-4 in a moment. OG still holding on to one, but actually drops it. Doesn't play back to get it converted.
That's
Batting
huge.
Stance keeps I'm So Strong alive to put that seventh bolt in as well.
That's huge. This is going to be the siege now for IX. This very well will determine the winners here. And how positioned are IX to make this push? They still have the super there for Dylan. He drops it now to try and create a path for the siege bot to move in. Tyrant Star keeps it in range, but Bobby has now fallen. OG is low, but they're keeping them pushed out still. Slash drops the super 96%. They need to get below 75, and they've done it. IX will come away with this first win.
Oh, Bobby going down there was disastrous. He had the magic hand to pull the siege bot away. The opportunity was there, but just too much. The movement only bounty.
Brawl Ball and then here just now on siege have sealed it for me, right? He's looked excellent on these last two modes. So let's move in once more. BB Sandy and the Gene on the top side there for IX. Meanwhile, it will be the Sandy, BB, and the Spike for Space Station.
The first bolt is going towards IX, but another one going to be turned in for SSG. Bobby very, very forward on this Sandy. I don't know if he has the help pool for that. The Rude Sands is enough to kill him. Magic Hand pulling in OG. Not enough to finish him off, though.
So and Strong wins his match.
Curveball shot there. Doesn't find anybody. So all these kills going the way of IX, but these respawns might be able to use the immunity to tank the siege bot as it comes in.
Those might run out here by this point. Let's see if anything comes from this big push. I'm So Strong with the super. Finds one critical kill. Tyrant Star dropped two. Now it's just OG. This is huge. Dylan has the magic hand as well to pull OG away and find the kill. They get in a ton of damage off this first push. Now IX up 37%.
Great use of the magic hand by Dylan. I think that's been a huge difference maker. Originally, Bobby was on it. I don't think the magic hand was working quite out, so they swapped things around. But now you can see what it really can do on this mode. So much going on. Bolt control still in favor of IX. They have this mid ground pretty locked down. Pull comes in, and Bobby goes down on the right side.
Bobby does indeed end up getting pulled. That's the super there from Iso Strong, just to get some damage onto OG. Tyrant Star falls here yet again. It's starting to feel like a bit of a collapse now from Space Station. Their fans need them to rally around this final push and not let IX move in and grab 63% off of it. They do push back the siege bot here once. The super comes out from OG as well for nice chip damage, but Slash yet again is going to loop around on the backside and find some decent damage. Iso Strong drops, and that will slow down the push, but it's down to 24%. Slash falls on the exit, but they get a bunch of work off that siege bot.
And even then, IX have had control of the bolts this entire time. They're about to be up 4-3. OG trying to make a difference, but you gotta be afraid of pushing that gene. If he gets that magic hand and you're not ready, you can go down right away. Bobby overextends into the sandstorm and goes down. They traded for I'm So Strong, and there's so many neutral bolts, but they're going down to try to chase them.
Finds a big kill. Tyrant Star, though, does do some work to find one kill at 6-5. Tyrant Star might have spawned this for them, but inside the sand, it wasn't enough. They have one siege bot. They're gonna have to do so much work with this push. They have to be in position to make sure it gets in for sustained damage.
And they have so much counter tools. They have the pull. They had the BB knockback with the home run, but she goes down early. Immune shield might be enough. Magic Hand on the side is going to pull, but can they get the damage on their own?
That's a big pull there from the Magic Hand that brings the siege bot off, but they make Dylan pay for it. They have got to make this push work. 81% on it. It's not going to be enough. It's IX that do enough damage to close this out. They will be your North American representatives and are your winners here in the finals.